feel like I could make a montage of how many times you got a ticket sitting in your driveway, dude.
What the fuck is the deal with Oklahoma? I literally can't have a car sitting in my driveway. Dude, I had an insurance lap for 4 days.
Oh, my God.
That means that there was a four-day window that whoever drove by and
there's
took a
video. Literally a dude on the computer just watching your shit it's all the time. Be. 24/7, like, oh, he doesn't have insurance. Get his ass. Go.
Thanks, Obama.
Bacon cream pies in your mom's eyes. Bacon cream pies all the time.
Wasting my shoe.
I hate tomatoes, but I love ketchup.
Can't find it. I'm looking for it.
Thing, and it's not even true.
Please, I have to shit. Drive home.
I think about you. I have to say,
it was hard
to leave you alone.
I think I'm gonna shit my pants.
Please, God, help me leave you alone.
Yo. Fucking. We were open on Christmas, but we didn't say shit about it. Because we don't give a fuck. But also, I kind of wanted to open this one with a solemn note. Super solemn and sad.
Mm-hmm.
And, I don't know. I'm just fucking saying words.
Oh,
now.
I'm like, I was like, who died?
Oh, yeah, I was trying to think of, like, somebody who was dead, but
the plane guy, did he die?
No, dude, he's forever living. He's probably been dead for, like, 40 years, but he's still alive in our hearts.
Yeah. I feel like I saw something just the other day, somebody died.
The plane.
Phenomenal.
I love that shit.
It's fucking solid.
It's the dude, plane guy.
Fuck, man. Yeah, how was Christmas? This is the day after Christmas, everybody. We're convening a day later than average.
Yo, it was okay.
Yeah.
But I don't know.
It'd be like that. The older you get, the less you give a shit at all.
Yeah, I kind of really didn't want to do it. I think it's my first Christmas. It's not. I've been here for 3 years.
Yeah.
I don't fucking know, dude.
Yeah.
But anyway, yeah, it sucked ass. Pretty much, really. I didn't give anybody a list, so they just gave me a bunch of like shirts and stuff that don't fit me.
Nice, yeah.
That's awesome.
I just tell people don't get me stuff, just get stuff for the kids. And then what I do is
I tell them to not get me stuff too, but they're just like, yeah, we're gonna get you some shit you don't want.
Yeah, I know. You have to be like, don't get it for me, get it for my cat. Tell them to get it for cat dog or something, and then they'll do it. You have to give them somebody else to buy the money for, so that way they feel like they've done their job. But I love it because then what happens is everybody gets my kids nicer gifts than me, and it leaves me more money to buy myself a nice Christmas present.
Hey.
Which I did this year. I got a DRC 300E brushless RC, and it's been a giant piece of shit. Brakes nonstop.
Dang old RC car.
Yeah. They keep sending me stuff for free,
though. I thought Lexi got you that.
I mean, she let me pick.
Oh, okay.
She gave me a budget. She was like, $85, pick one on Amazon.
Right on.
Yeah, because she ran over the one that I originally had gotten, which was the Cadillac.
Okay. I got you. So I wanted to start off with the motherfucking top 5 Christmas foods.
Okay.
So what we got? What do you got in your brain there?
My absolute number one is broccoli casserole.
Broccoli casserole. Big fan.
One of my favorite fucking foods ever, dude.
It's fucking good.
Simple. You know, it's just broccoli, cheese, Ritz crackers, done.
It's fucking good.
If you want to spice it up, put it over some white rice, make a whole
meal
out of it.
Do you have like full broccoli or you cut it up?
Sometimes we do it both ways. So the way my mom used to do it was she would just get a big head of broccoli, and then just like dice it up randomly, you know, and we would just have like random fucking cubes in it.
Oh yeah.
Me and Lex sometimes we'll do with the smaller stems, the florets, I think they call it, when you buy the bag of broccoli florets where it's not got the meaty part at the bottom.
Oh yeah.
And I kind of like that one better because the meaty part, sometimes the rind on it's a little bit plasticky, you know?
Yep.
But at the same time, I kind of like the flavor of the big meaty part too. You know, it's got a different kind of flavor than the top half. So I don't know if I can really distinguish the two different flavors. It's just like the top tastes more like broccoli and the bottom tastes less like broccoli. That's all I can really say.
I guess I'm going to go with hash brown casserole for mine.
Oh, dude.
Fucking good. Yeah. My grandma, she uses like fucking Frosted Flakes for the top. It's not actually Frosted Flakes, but like corn flakes for the top, and then just hash brown casserole, normal, but phenomenal, dude. Can't go wrong. Oh, yeah. Go ahead. Go for number two.
Oh, mashed potatoes, dude.
Mashed potatoes.
Chunky, homemade mashed potatoes.
Has to be chunky, yeah. Dude.
With
you
the skins.
Got, yeah, you got to have skins in there.
So good.
If there's no skins, get the fuck out of here.
Yeah, dude. I don't want your instant potatoes.
Yeah, if it's that fucking minute make shit. What are we doing?
Yeah.
But yeah, I want to do baked macaroni, dude.
Yo.
Wah.
Yep. That was going to be my next one.
Yeah, so. Dude. I haven't had that in years, though. Nobody ever makes it. It's fucking good.
Yeah. It's fucking, I love the crust on top. I don't even know what people put on it. Is it breadcrumbs that they put on the top and it gets the crust?
I think, yeah, it's just breadcrumbs and then cheese. And then they fucking let that cheese fucking harden.
Yeah.
And then you get the breadcrumbs on there.
Dude, I like it when they burn it just a little bit. Just a little bit of burn where it's nice and brown on the edges. Oh,
so it's good. Fucking good, man.
Yeah, fat guy's talking about food. You guys are in the right place.
What else you got?
Cranberry sauce. Fresh cranberry
fuck
sauce.
Fuck that shit,
no,
dude.
Lex makes the best,
what do you
dude.
Put it? You put it on your turkey or what?
I just eat it.
Cranberry
I just
sauce.
Eat it. Yeah.
That's gnarly. Not me.
No.
I'm not a cranberry guy. Mm. Yeah.
I love cranberries, dude.
We can throw desserts in here, right?
I mean, that's what cranberry sauce is.
Okay, I'm going to go with fucking banana pudding.
Yeah? Do you think at Christmas?
With, I don't know. I mean, I never get it, but I'm sure that it fits in.
Yeah, I could see that. Gah! Gah! Now, do you do it with vanilla wafers in it?
Yes.
Yeah.
Dude. It's the mint.
So good.
All right, go for round three, and then I think we'll cut it on three.
Well, this is four.
Oh, shit. Do you have a fourth?
Yeah.
Okay, go for it.
Fresh bread.
Fresh bread.
Fresh bread is my favorite thing at Christmas, actually, probably number one.
What kind of bread are y'all using?
Oh, yeah, fresh white bread, dude. A nice, fluffy fucking, you know, it's where the outside's got a nice thick crust and it's crunchy, you know, because I like to dip it in my fucking different casseroles I got. I'll sop up the juices from it on it. I'll put fucking cranberry sauce on the bread. Like, it's the multi-tool of your Thanksgiving dinner. You can mix it with anything that you're eating, and it's perfect.
Yeah, I'm a big roll guy.
Rolls?
I feel like I use it kind of, like, as a palate cleanser, but or something. You know, I'll be, like, eating turkey and all that shit, and then I'll just eat the bread. And so now I've hit my base, and I can start.
And now you're ready to start tasting your wines,
Yeah. No,
yeah. What's a chablis?
What's I just that? Spit all over the floor and shit.
What the fuck is that about? Like, what about a wine testing is elegant or anything? You fucking put a little bit in your mouth, switch around, spit it out, and you're like, tastes like grapes. Give me another one.
I don't get that shit. But also, it doesn't taste like grapes. It tastes like a fucking asshole.
I like wine.
Wine be tasting fucking weird, man.
It tastes like grape juice that got left out. That's what it tastes like. It tastes like spoiled grape juice. That's what it is.
I guess I'm not an alcohol guy.
Yeah, Lexi and me used to get this Jew wine, and it's like... It's I don't know what it's for, but it says it's blessed and it's kosher and whatnot, and it's got, you know, Star of David and all that all over the bottle. They sell it at Winn-Dixie, was where we would always get it, and it was like $9 a bottle. And it was like 16%, dude. It was like really strong.
So it tastes like dog water.
No, it tasted amazing. It tasted like candy. You couldn't even taste the alcohol at all, dude. It literally tasted like Welch's grape juice. Just sitting there, you were like, holy fuck, it's so sweet. I don't know how they did it. I don't think it was like a normal type of wine. I think it was like a mead. Type deal, you know? I don't know if you ever had a mead, but they're extremely sweet.
I haven't.
No.
For my number four, I will go with the bread thing, but I'm going to go with beer bread.
Yo.
So my mom makes this beer bread and it has this crust on the top where it's like crumbly.
Mm-hmm.
The rest of it is like just cake type. And it's fucking good, man.
Fuck yeah, dude. I haven't had a beer bread in a long time.
Beer bread is good, man. Just being bread. Yeah.
Fuck, man.
Beer be making shit good. Like beer, meat.
Fish, yeah.
Making meat good, man. It's fucking good.
We used to do beer can fish all the time. And that was like my grandpa and my grandma. Well, they did Sprite can. They did Sprite instead of beer because they didn't drink. But that was their big thing. But my dad, whenever he would.
Well, it gets the alcohol out of it.
I know, but I think it was the whole point of my grandpa quit drinking, you know.
Okay.
And it's like, I don't know, scared to relapse or whatever. Don't know. But, dude, you know, fucking just take a beer, dude, crack it open, put it in the grill next to the shit while you're cooking it.
Right.
You're done.
It just keeps it fucking moist, right? Oh,
so good. It's not even just that, but it puts the flavor in there. Mm-hmm. You get done that. So good. Best chicken.
So good. Yeah. I mean, with number five.
Number five for me, let me think, what do I normally eat at Christmas time? What the fuck was that?
I don't know. Somebody mowing their shit.
I'm going to have to put in a sound here because they're not going to understand what
a
that
is. Drone strike.
Yeah. Then like somebody with a really big RC car, and I was like, man, maybe I should go challenge them.
You're fucking whack, man. You're all into these RCs right now.
Oh, dude, it's so fun. Pumpkin pie, dude. Honestly.
Pumpkin pie.
I'm a big pumpkin pie guy.
It's busting.
Yeah.
Hey, pumpkin pie, man.
Yeah, it's what it is, you know?
Killing it.
Yeah, I can't believe that elderly Italian lady, dude. She hates it so much.
Yeah, she's the best.
Pumpkin pie, man.
I wanted to get her on the pod, but she's too good for us.
Yeah.
Even though we named our podcast after that fucking video.
Yeah, what an obscure ordeal.
Yeah. I want to go with stuffing. Stuffing's pretty good.
Ooh, yeah.
It depends on what it is.
Yeah, if it's like, you ever have like giblet stuffing? It's where it's like the giblet gravy, but they put it in the stuffing. Mm-mm. So it's got like all the organs from the turkey. They get like the gizzard and all that. No. You ever have giblet gravy? Oh, never mind.
But yeah, stuffing, I just eat it with the turkey, but it's kind of busting.
Mm-hmm. I even like cheap ass, like stoked up fucking
stuffing. Yeah. I don't know. Like, I've kind of gone away from stuffing. I didn't eat any this year. So, I don't know. But stuffing's a good one. Everybody loves that shit.
Yeah.
But I guess another one that's like from my family is just they'll take Doritos and then put the leftover turkey on it, like grind it up and put it on there. So it's just ground turkey pretty much and just nachos.
Yeah, that sounds sick.
Yeah.
What we used to do was my grandma always made this rice, and I fucking don't know what brand of rice it was, but they were huge, big ass chunks of white rice. And it always had like this really creamy flavor. It was really good because she put so much butter in it. And then I would just take the gravy and the leftover turkey and dump that all in there and fucking...
There you go.
Delicious.
Big time.
You know what we should do, man, one of these days? We should get a couple of different fucking pumpkin pies and we should do a fucking pumpkin pie review.
Good old taste test.
Yeah.
God. That would be awesome. Yeah, let's do it on the next one.
Yeah. We need to hit like the different stores and be like, okay, this one's from fucking Crest. This one's from Walmart. That's going to be the annoying ass part is going to all these different stores to look for
pumpkin pie.
Well,
we just get different brand of pie.
Yeah, but there's only like two brands of pumpkin pie at a fucking Walmart.
Yeah, Edwards is going to win.
Edwards, I don't even think they make a pumpkin pie. Do they?
They make pecan pie. It's my favorite pecan pie. Even though it's probably dog shit.
it's not as good as like a one that you make, but it's not bad.
It's fucking good, dude. Anyway, that's the... Enough talk. Let's fight.
Yeah.
That's Christmas. Christmas talk.
Yeah, dude. Yeah, we're done with Christmas. What's been going on in the world, man? It seems like I haven't really seen a whole lot popping up. I've been out of Facebook for a minute now, so I'm kind of out of the loop.
The election.
Is it?
It's coming up.
In February?
I have no idea, but it's coming up. And I think Trump is running, but he also had like... I saw some shit about his fourth indictment or whatever.
Yeah, I didn't think you could run if you got indicted.
That would make sense, right?
That'd be like, what if Nixon ran again immediately?
I know, right? So that's strange. But
the most annoying thing is that it doesn't even matter if he actually runs or not. He's going to stir up so much shit that this election is going to be pointless.
Yeah, I think I want to watch this year.
I think it's going to be probably two more elections before we get anywhere back
when
on track.
When do you think
company,
we're going to have our first woman president? Never happening. Not in our lifetime.
No.
I mean, we have to wait till Hillary's dead.
Yeah.
Right? Because...
That's the problem, is that she's going to get the majority of women's votes, and there's not a...
Why do they like her?
I don't know, because she's a powerful and successful woman, I guess.
She's a woman.
It's literally, I think that's all it is that she's only the only name that comes up to the top of the ballots, you know? Like, there was Joe Jorgensen last time around, but she was a fucking libertarian, which is an issue, and then... also, nobody cared because it wasn't bipartisan, you know? So she got, like, more votes than Kanye, but not anywhere near enough.
Dude, do you think Bernie's gonna run?
No, he's given up, he said.
Yeah, I hope so, because he was fucking weird, man.
I wanted him to win just to see what the fuck would happen, dude.
I think it would be okay, but
what's the worst that weird guy's gonna... He dies immediately, and then we get stuck with some idiot as the vice president? That's what fucking Biden's gonna do if he wins again.
Dude, yo, how long was Biden vice president?
8 years.
Oh, okay. Who was he vice president for?
Obama.
Obama.
Yeah.
I'm not.
It's weird because I thought that maybe he would bring a little bit of that same kind of charisma over. Maybe he learned a little bit, but no.
Dude, he's completely different. He doesn't even look the same.
No, he doesn't.
I've seen some older videos. Dead. Yeah, he's brain dead, he's man. They probably fucking put a robot in his head.
He's just going to go down in history as one of the most forgettable presidents, dude. Like, it's literally, he hasn't done anything that's super significant.
Well, yeah, that's true. But he pulled out of Afghanistan, so that's one. That'll go down in history books.
Sure. Obama started it, though. That's the thing, is that it's like a continuation of a policy that started fucking 8 years ago.
And then, I don't know what else he did. I mean, shit, if World War III starts, like, next month, then he did that.
He didn't, you know what I mean? Like, that's the thing, is it's hard to blame him for any of the shit that's actually been going on. It's, you can't give him credit for any of the good shit, and it's hard to blame him for any of the bad shit. He's just been a fucking face. That's it. He's just the face up there.
Well, that's what every president is.
I know, but at least most of them fucking will rile people up and be like, oh, you should really care about this one thing. But Biden's just like, I really like Corvettes and sniffing people's hair.
I don't know. I fuck with it, dude. I kind of like him a little more than I did before. Like, when he got into office, I didn't really give a shit.
Yeah, yeah.
But now I'm like, this guy's kind of fucking funny, dude.
Yeah. Like, I think he's interesting. I don't have anything bad about him. I'm not going to be one of those guys that's like, fucking, let's go Brandon or whatever they say.
Yeah, what is that?
I don't fucking know.
It's because it's not let's go Brandon. It's like, fuck you, Biden or something. They were saying it at a baseball game, and there was a guy named Brandon in the game. So they were like, they were saying let's go Brandon. They're trying to hide it.
Yeah.
Stupid.
Yeah, it's dumb. It's fucking peak boomer humor. They're like,
hey, there was big boomer humor.
This is this thing that's not at all funny, and it's literally doesn't do anything except for offend people. That's boomer humor. It doesn't do anything but piss people off. So that's it.
You know what I thought was really funny was, like, and it's not even fucking funny, but I was like, I was looking at the Declaration of Independence with one of my buddies from work, and I was just like, that. I was like, hey man, you want to sign one? And it was just the dumbest shit in the world. Like,
yeah,
but.
There's been a couple of different places in the United States that have tried to secede. Like, obviously not the fucking Confederacy, but like
Texas?
Not just Texas. There's been like smaller cities that have like 100, 200 people, and they've tried to make their own charter and become sovereign territories, but it doesn't really work. I think there was one that did, and that's because the guy bought the land from Native Americans, and because that was not in U.S. jurisdiction, he was able to become sovereign.
Dude, you can probably just do anything if you're Native.
Yeah, if you're in your land, they have laws. They have very strict laws.
Native Americans?
Yeah, I mean, some of them, I mean, it's just their own little country. So whatever that they vote for, those laws become laws, and sometimes they're way more strict, sometimes they're way more lenient, you know? Because a sense of tribal identity, dude, and culture plays into the laws, too.
So, fucking Canada. Like, was Canada owned by France?
Yeah.
All of Canada?
No. Some of it was owned by England.
Where is France? Like, way the fuck out of here, right?
By England.
Yeah, it's fucking far away.
Literally across the English Channel from England.
What the fuck were they doing here fighting the Indians? They were here before us. Because they owned Canada, right?
They weren't here before us.
They were fucking with the Indians before we were.
No, we got here in Jamestown way before them. We didn't become the 13 colonies until way later, but the United States has been occupied longer. And the French didn't just even have, shit, they man. Had like Quebec and stuff like that, but like Nova Scotia and shit like that, I think was not. And what's really crazy is that Canadian money still has the queen on. the English queen.
Really?
Yeah. Canada's weird. They don't speak French all in Canada. It's only in like two or three of the territories.
Like, yeah, like Quebec.
Yeah. That's it. So I don't know. I think that what happened was, I think that the French got to that territory because they came up from Louisiana and they had everything north before the Louisiana Purchase.
So who inhabited Canada then?
What do you mean? Like the natives?
Yeah, well, who are the people that live there today?
Canadians?
I'm saying like who got there? Like who went? Was it us? We went up there?
No, they went there whenever the French territories, whenever the French were living throughout that whole center.
It's a bunch of French people? With accents like ours?
No, the people in Canada have very unique Canadian accents.
Yeah, but they don't have, like, French.
In Quebec, yeah.
Yeah, absolutely. In Quebec, but they don't have it in fucking...
No, there are bits of it, no.
That's what I'm saying.
No, that was the English, yeah. English, Germans.
The English people.
English, Germanish, the Danish.
Oh, I just think their accent is fucking weird.
Well, it depends on what part you're
from. It sounds pretty much like us, except they have like the oot or sorry.
It's only some of the places, but people in Wisconsin sound like that too.
Yeah.
And so do people in like North Dakota.
It's just all the people from Wisconsin moved up there.
So the reason that those areas have that kind of sound is because of the amount of fucking like Swedish and Scandinavian people who moved out there. That's why like the Minnesota Vikings is the team. Like that's their whole heritage is built off of people who did that, you know. Like hurdy gurdy hurdy, you know, so they fucking talk like that.
Hurdy dirty.
Yeah, they sound like the fucking guy who was the cashier in Frozen.
Half off swimming suits, clogs, and a sunbelt of my own invention. Yeah.
Oh yeah, fuck that guy.
He was hilarious, dude.
I didn't watch Frozen, but fuck that guy for having that accent.
Oh.
Yeah. Well. Oh man, you ever been to the Epcot?
No.
From Disney World or whatever. Yeah. Oh my god, dude! They take all the biggest stereotypes of like the place and they just make a spot for it.
Yeah.
So like I went to the Canadian one and it literally is that shop with like the hurdy-gurdy dude.
Nice.
Oh my god. And that's all of Canada in the Epcot. You just go there and they have a store and they're wearing like the weird overalls and shit.
Nice. What's the fucking Tim Hortons, the pancake place that's a big deal?
Oh, yeah, I don't know.
It's like McDonald's in Canada, but they sell pancakes and it's like everybody in Canada just eat pancakes?
Apparently they have like the best coffee too. I don't know.
I want to go to Canada. We have to go to Canada.
We need to go to Canada. We have to go to Canada.
I want
to
go fight a polar bear and die immediately.
I don't want to do that.
One hit, dude.
No.
You think a polar bear could take my head off in one hit? One swipe.
I want to go to Ontario and just be like, oh, hey.
You just immediately get your ass beat.
Do you think that if, like, we just showed up and we didn't say any words for a while, like, people would think that we're Canadians?
No.
No.
I think that there's...
Do you think Canadians are, like... They could probably just tell because we're fat, right?
I think...
Because they're not fat in Canada.
Yeah, because their mayors smoke crack.
Do they have fat people in Canada?
Yeah.
Is it a lot?
I think it's less than us, but yeah.
It's got to be a lot. It's got to be, like, 30% less than us.
You know, I don't know. Let me look. Let's see what the obesity rate here is, and then the obesity rate.
I think obesity rate here is, like, 70%.
Dude. Yeah, it's got to be pretty big. I mean, I'm a fat guy. Like, I'm a really fat guy, but what's crazy is I could name 50 people that are way yeah, 50 than
people
me.
That look like they ate you.
Yeah.
It's fucked up, dude. Oh, my God. I was watching a video, and it was a guy who was, like, or there's people who are advocates of being fat, right?
Yeah.
So there's fat people, and they're like, we're not even that fat. We're blah, blah, blah. And the dude who was doing it, he showed the video of them, like, advocating for fat people. And then he was like, yeah, but it's okay because she died at 36. And then the next one, she died at 33. And the next one, I was like, that's so fucked.
Okay. So among men, the prevalence of obesity was over 8%. Lower in Canada than in the United States. So 8% is really, it's a big difference, but it's not that big of a difference. Among women, it was 12% lower. So fatter guys and skinnier women.
Is it actually 20% in total, though?
Well, you can't combine the two different ones. No. It's 8% for men, 12% for women. So the women in Canada are skinnier.
So it's like 10%.
You can't average it out between the two. That's assuming a perfect 50-50 spread of the men versus women.
Oh, yeah, I get it.
Yeah. So, no, the average, yeah, I guess the average would be 10%. Yeah, I get what you're saying.
Yeah, it's close.
Yeah, so.
They're like 10% less fat than us.
Yeah. It's 30 pounds less.
So they still have like airsoft fatty chilling out there.
Yeah, he's from fucking Michigan. He's from Battle Creek, Michigan. I only know that because iDubbbz did the video making fun of him. Did you ever see the fucking iDubbbz Sam Hyde thing? Sam Hyde just clowned on him, dude. He fucking hired all these actors. Like, he hired this one girl to pretend she was his crackhead girlfriend and that he was, like, taking advantage of her crackhead situation to get her to do random shit for crack. Like, just random shit. It was hilarious. And iDubbbz made a whole video where he was like, what the fuck is Sam Hyde doing? And he did, like, a fucking 2-hour video. And then Sam Hyde did a video afterwards. He was like, we fucking got you, bitch! All these people were actors. Idiot! You think I make all this money and I work out of a fucking closet with a bunch of sweaty idiots drooling all over their computer?
Oh, shit.
Dude, it was so fucking funny.
Dude.
It was wild, actually.
Have you seen those videos where they, like, give homeless people money and the homeless guy's like, yeah. Okay. There's one guy.
You ever seen bum fights?
Yeah. There's one guy who's going out and he's, like, giving them money and they're like, oh, thanks, man. And he's like, oh, wait. And he, like, takes it back. He's like, let me hold that for a second. He takes it back, and they're like, what? And then he gives him, like, 7 parking tickets. And he's like, yeah, that's 7 parking tickets. Fuck you. And they get fucking mad, and yeah. It's hilarious. I'm like, God damn, bro.
You imagine you get pulled over, and he's like, you know why I pulled you over today, sir? Like, you don't know my taillight? He's like, no, man, you won a free prize. We're going on a cruise next week. Come on, let's go.
Just kidding. I'm hitting you with 10 violations.
Yeah, actually, I need you to get out of the car and take off your pants because I'm going to shove this baton all the way up.
Oh, shit.
Dude, I just got another ticket.
Why you be getting ticket? Is it from in your driveway?
Yeah, somebody got a picture. They scanned my license plate and I didn't have insurance on the car sitting in my driveway. So I got a $200 fucking ticket.
I feel like I could make a montage of how many times you got a ticket sitting in your driveway, dude.
What the fuck is the deal with Oklahoma? I literally can't have a car sitting in my driveway. Dude, I had an insurance lap for 4 days.
Oh, my God.
That means that there was a 4-day window that whoever drove by and
there's
took a
video. Literally a dude on the computer just watching your shit all the time. It's gotta be. 24/7, like... Oh, he doesn't have insurance. Get his ass. Go. Dude, like, send him.
They got me the one time, and they fucking told me, they said, if you have more than 2 tires in the grass of your yard, you're allowed to have 1 tire, but more than 2 tires. 2 tires or more in the grass, that's a ticket.
Right on.
What the fuck's the point of having a front yard? Can't use the damn thing.
I don't know. I had a car in my yard. I had 2 cars in my yard.
Yeah.
At all times in Georgia.
Yeah.
Because my driveway was a 1-car driveway. Yeah.
Like, so. It's crazy because my mom's property, there isn't a driveway. It's just a yard, and we just drive randomly through the fucking yard. I mean, there's a driveway now, but, you know. Well, I don't understand the whole Oklahoma City thing. It's not like I live in a nice neighborhood, dude.
Yeah.
Yeah, do you know how many fucking bums shuffle their way down my road literally every day? I'll be outside playing with the RC car, dude. Now, and I'll see them. They walk from the fucking apartments, they have a shopping cart, and they start rooting through people's garbage, which, like, hey, man, you're going to make a living and whatnot. Whatever, that's fine. But they just fucking throw the garbage everywhere and just leave.
Oh, right on.
Make a big fucking mess.
Hell yeah. I guess I would do the same thing if I was, like, drugged out. Yeah. I would get what I need, and then yeah. I would just be like, fuck
but
this.
But here's my thing.
This up.
Why is my car having no insurance sitting in my driveway a problem, but fucking meth heads throwing garbage all over the place is not an issue?
Dude, okay, so the most genuine bums, not genuine, but, like, they are bums. I guess that's what genuine is, right? Like, they're the most bum people that live here in the city are fucking on 44th and the highway.
Yeah.
When I get off there, they're the most, like, real bums.
Yeah.
So they're just like, hey, man.
Actually.
Well, they never talk to me. I just give them cigarettes every time I go over
General
there.
General Pershing Boulevard. They will put tents in the middle of the road. And just laying in the middle of the road. Yeah. It's over by Baker. I went over there one time to go pick up a fucking belt or something for Paul, and the road was blocked.
Yeah, I've seen it.
Just sitting in the middle of the road. And I was like, man, I really don't know my way around this town for you guys to be doing this shit to me. Now I got to turn around and fucking backtrack and try to find my way to Baker. I only know one way to get there.
Told me about it once. We were actually driving through there, and he was telling me, I used to come out here. Fucking, I don't know. You know how he is. He, like, fucks with bums, man. He was probably, like, on bum fights, honestly, dude.
Dude, he
probably has fought Kimbo Slice in his lifetime.
Did he tell you about the time that he fucking went up to this guy's house and was just like, bang, bang, bang on the door, fucking looked inside, then ran into the truck?
Shit, yeah.
Dude, it was like a fucking one-bedroom house on the side of the Dollar General. And
dude, there's this one time I was really scared because we were at, we were doing a Walgreens. We had just got there, and this dude cracked out his fucking mind, like, talking to himself and fucking, like, doing this outside. Like, you were there.
Yeah, daywalkers. I wasn't at the Walgreens.
Oh, okay.
But
okay.
I know the guys you're talking about. I see him all the time, dude.
That motherfucker was whacked out, and he was, like, walked past, and he's just like, motherfucker, right? And then somebody else walks past, and he's just yelling at him. And then so me and are taking this ladder all the way up to the fucking roof from the outside, so it's, like, full extension.
Yeah.
And we're, like, halfway up the ladder, and decides he wants to yell at this guy and get in a fight with him. And I was like, fucking move it along, because this dude's going to kick the ladder out, and I'm going to die. I was scared, man.
Yeah. Dude, he's a problem, but fucking so was, dude. We had one of those, the drivers, he was, like, you know, the Arabic guys that would drive the little trucks dropping off the produce coolers.
Sure, yeah.
there was one of them, and he had really strong accent, but he was like really chill guy. He just asked a lot. He kept coming out, hey, can you guys get off my truck now? You know, real quick.
Sure.
And he's like, and we're like, no, man, we can't do it yet. No, man, we can't do it yet. And every time we're like, dude, it's not here. We can't do it yet. We have to wait for him to get here because he's the only one who can fucking pull it off. Well, he came up to and was like, go in the wheel, are you? No! And then he just walked away. And the guy came up to me. He's like, what the fuck is wrong with your friend? I was like, I don't know, dude.
I'm he's just, crazy, man.
Dude, I'm just trying to work.
Dude, yeah, had something going on, man. Do you think that back when the only two jobs were hunting and gathering, what do you think you would be, a gatherer or a hunter?
I'm a man, so they would have definitely made me a hunter.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, it's kind of the luck of the draw, man.
What if you couldn't hunt? You're just then ass.
Well, then they would probably just
banish your ass.
They would just let you die.
They would just kill you.
No, they wouldn't kill you. They just wouldn't be like...
starve.
Yeah, they're like, hey, we're going to hunt this saber-toothed tiger, and you're coming with us. And then you get in a situation, you're like, hey, guys, I need help. And they're like, no.
You have to kill it yourself.
Yeah, and then you don't. And then while it's attacking you and you die, they kill it. And then they still get to eat, and you're out of the way. And clean conscience. Everybody's happy.
Fucking hell.
Yeah, I mean, that'd be a tough gig. We didn't really have fucking mammoths here, did we? We had mastodons here in the United States. Is that right?
What the fuck? I don't know.
Dude, what an idiot.
Oh, yeah. Oh, the entire United States was water, and we had mastodons. Oh, wait, no. I'm sorry. I thought you were saying megalodons for some reason. I got that mixed up.
No, I'm talking about I don't think we actually had mammoths, though. I think we had mastodons, which are, like, similar, but not at all the same, because one of them's got a big old stinky forehead, and he's voiced by Ray Romano, and the other one doesn't.
Like, it smells just bad? The yeah. Forehead?
Yeah. It's got visible
stink. What are you excreting, man? Yeah. No. We got some real good trains in Bangor. I gotta show you that shit, dude. We were putting it in the pod.
You know, I was told that I wasn't supposed to swear in here tonight. But I just know that there are some great fucking trains here in Bangor.
Okay. Fucking.
It's just Sebastian Bach. That's what he sounds like.
Dude.
What are you excreting out of your forehead, man?
I don't like him.
But he's funny.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, I know, but like, what did he do for society outside of 18 in life?
18 in life, you got it. 18 in life to go. What is that?
That's him.
Like,
what kind of name is Sebastian Bach? Was your mom a chicken?
Bach.
Was your mom a chicken? His last name's not Bach. He's not German.
I know, he changed it for sure.
Yeah.
Because he... is a composer.
Yeah. Fucking, that's what I'm going to start calling myself. I'm gonna, like, I'm a composer. I did yeah.
Okay. yeah, dude. I'd probably be a motherfucking... guy who, like, travels the land, whatever those guys are called.
Drifter?
No, like, in Avatar, where they're all...
nomads?
Yeah, bam.
Go live in Mongolia, dude.
I don't want to do that.
It looks beautiful.
I don't want to live in Mongolia.
They drink fucking yak milk.
Yeah.
They ferment it, it's called Eriag, and then they get drunk on fermented yak milk.
That's gnarly, dude.
Yeah, I've heard it tastes like what you would think.
Yeah, imagine drinking spoiled milk all the time and getting fucked up.
Yeah, do you think it has any kind of like hallucinogenic shit to it? Like absinthe, or do you think it's just alcohol?
Imagine being lactose intolerant and then having to drink yak milk all the time.
Yeah, not even that. Imagine like you're fucking lactose intolerant severely, but you also need like anesthetic because you're severely wounded and they're just like dumping this fucking yak milk beer down your throat and you're just like fucking shitting your pants and also vomiting.
How many people you think died of dysentery back then?
Fucking all of them.
All of them, dude.
They live like that now.
Holy shit.
They still live like that now.
Hell yeah.
There's a bunch of the nomads that live in Mongolia that still fucking... I mean, Mongolia is like the least densely populated...
I thought nomad means like you're going all over the fucking world.
No, it just means you're not settled. That's all a nomad is. I mean, you can be a nomad who goes all over the world, but the people of Mongolia, they live... not all of them, obviously. Not every Mongolian is a fucking camel riding person who survives in the desert, but a big portion. It's the least densely populated place in the world, which is pretty wild when you think about it. It's less densely populated than the fucking rainforest.
That is wild.
How do they keep track of people who are living in places like that? How do they know how many people live there?
They don't.
Yeah, right? So how the fuck can you make
it's a statement like that? It's all a guess.
Yeah.
Do they- I don't know. Dude, yo, what the fuck, man? Why is there like... Okay, so I saw this another thing, and it's one of those fake videos like we were talking about last time, but it's like a dude found a megalodon that was bigger than the biggest megalodons that we think existed.
Mm-hmm.
And they're like, and it's true because there's only 5% of the oceans that we've ever done or ever seen or whatever. And it's yeah. like, okay, it could be true. Could there's be. Probably really big sharks out there. But the
problem
there.
Is that it doesn't support your thesis.
Yeah, it doesn't. Yeah.
Just because it doesn't disprove it doesn't mean it proves it.
I know. It's just like, so how did the big megalodon get into the 5% that we can look at? You know what I mean? No, didn't happen.
You remember you were telling me a while back about the fucking sitcom where the monkey killed everybody?
Yeah. It's not even a sitcom. I figured out what it is.
It's from the movie Nope.
Yeah.
I was watching Nope last night, and I saw the monkey killing the people, and I was like, wait a minute. Is this one of those ones that Austin was telling me about that he saw, like, found footage of?
Yeah.
I was like, this is wild. Also, that movie kind of mid. I mean, like, it was really, really good, but it also, like,
is that the story one with the big anywhere. Alien?
Yeah, the big, yeah. It's a big stingray.
So I was talking about them as different things, but they're actually both.
Yeah.
Together.
What the fuck does the monkey have to do with anything? That guy ended up being completely irrelevant.
Yeah, I know.
I was waiting for them to be like, because they did the thing where he's down there, it's nighttime, he turns on all the lights, and he's all like, in 6 months, me and my family have seen crazy shit, and then the lights go off, and you hear all the screaming for the horses, and I was like, oh man, that guy's sacrificing people. And when I watched the trailer, there was like that seriously deformed lady going, ah! And I was like, holy fuck, they got zombies in this. No, she's just one of the ladies that got her face ripped off by a monkey, and she's standing in the audience, and she's, ah!
Yeah, and it has nothing to do with the story at all.
Why, yeah, what's the point of the flashbacks? I don't care.
Yeah.
His character didn't matter. He was just a fucking loser. It's just
because the dude from the show that lived, or the kid,
yeah.
was the guy who owned the park that the alien was at.
I know, yeah, but he ended up not mattering.
Yeah, it doesn't.
At
yeah.
all.
Yeah, it's kind of a whack movie, actually.
Yeah, I mean, like, there was a lot of it that was extremely interesting, right? Obviously, the cast, phenomenal. Cast did great.
Was it?
I thought the cast was amazing.
Really? Yeah. You liked the movie?
I would give the movie, like, 7 out of 10.
Wild.
Yeah.
I'm going to say, like, a 4. Really? Not even a 5, yeah.
I thought the cast was pretty good. I thought the characters were interesting.
Who's the main guy?
It's, I don't is know what his
Jonathan
name is.
Majors?
No. Oh. He's the dude from Get Out, and he was also in Black Panther.
Okay.
As the leader of, like, the Rhino tribe, the water tribe. You haven't seen that?
Yeah,
okay.
I don't know
what his name is. He's been in all kinds of shit. He's a phenomenal actor. And it's got Keke Palmer in it. And then the dad is, also, he's been in a million fucking things, dude. But then it was some of the ones that I didn't recognize the actor for that I was like, damn, these guys are doing pretty solid. They're keeping
dude,
up.
Dude, so you just watched it, right?
That's not, yeah.
Okay, so at the end with the fucking pictures with the fucking well, mm-hmm. what the fuck is that?
Proof.
What is happening?
They found proof.
Okay, so they're trying to prove that the alien exists.
Yeah, yeah.
But it ends up eating that lady, right?
No, ate her brother.
Oh, okay.
But the thing is, I don't think it was an alien. I think it was an angel. At the very beginning of the movie, there's a quote, which I believe is from the Quran. And in... Islamic beliefs, there's a lot of different angels and a lot of different like jinn and stuff like that. And at the end, when it stops being a big fucking sucker fish and it transforms, it gets like those big wings and starts growing, and it kind of matches the description from a lot of angels and stuff. And I think that's what it was. I honestly don't know, man. I need to rewatch it.
Weird plot, dude.
It's a Jordan Peele movie, so it's really artsy and it's very strange. Okay.
Yeah,
you know?
Right on.
And that's
he's the guy that does like Keanu, right?
Yeah, but he's also the guy who did like Get Out or Candyman. Right? He does
a
lot
seen
of
Get Out.
It's really fucking good. He does a lot of really good thriller and horror movies, dude. He's got a really good knack for it. Candyman, his remake of Candyman is like, it's cheesy and campy, but it's a remake of a B movie from the 80s. So you kind of want that. It stays true, you know.
Yeah,
I like that. That and he kind of has like the same revolving house of actors that he uses a bunch of the same people. And I think they just build good character with each other, you know? I mean,
yeah, I mean, he had Glenn. I mean, Glenn was the guy with the fucking monkey thing.
Yeah.
Which is Glenn from The Walking Dead.
Yeah. Yeah. He's also the kid from Invincible.
I mean, he's a good actor. What's his name?
Steven Yeun?
Wait, what?
His name's Steven Yeun, I think.
From Invincible? I haven't seen Invincible.
No. I mean, the actor's name.
Oh, I don't know.
Yeah. He's in all kinds of shit, though.
He's in a lot of shit, dude.
Everybody that's in that movie was, for the most part. There was only, like I said, two people who I really didn't recognize, and that was the cameraman that they ended up getting, which I thought he was great. He did a phenomenal job. Some of the stuff was kind of like when he fucking sacrificed himself to it for the perfect shot, but then the camera gets devoured, too. I was like...
Dude, you need to watch The Harder They Fall. It's on... Well, you don't have Netflix, huh? Anyway, The Harder They Fall, it's like a all-black cast, but it's a Western movie.
Okay.
And it has Jonathan Majors, who's...
Dude. One of the guys that I'm friends with on Facebook, he's a dude from Jacksonville. I think he went to La Villa, the art school. He is an up-and-coming actor, and he was in that.
Really?
Yeah, he was a relatively minor character, but he was in like four different episodes.
Wait, no, this is not an episode thing. It's a
movie. I thought you said it was a TV show.
No, it's a movie.
Well, he was, I'm pretty sure it's the same one, because he was in a movie with Jonathan Majors, and it was Black Cowboys.
The Harder They Fall.
I don't remember the name of the movie. I just remember him posting this stuff. But yeah, I remember he was a relatively... all I know is he was talking about how much camera time he's got.
Oh, okay.
But he mostly does, like, commercials. He did a Lexus commercial and some other stuff like that. But it's always neat to see people from the hometown fucking, you know, doing good stuff.
Yeah.
There's another dude I know named Brent who's fucking got a job at NASA now.
Wild.
Yeah, he's a fucking engineer. He does micro-soldering a lot. He posts videos of him, like, fixing the circuit boards on cell phones, you know, where he's got, like, a fucking... one of those microscopes where he, like, clicks the lenses over so he can zoom in, and he's got, like, cool fucking... He's doing all crazy shit. Yeah, I don't really like getting on Facebook too much at all anymore, but I'll get on when I'm working on the pod sometimes, you know, I'm messaging you shit while I'm working on it.
Yeah.
And while it'll upload the screen every like 3 minutes, it'll update and it'll keep all these people. I see, oh, cool. You know, half of the people that I went to school with are doing worse than me and the other half are doing so much better than me that it's laughable.
Yeah. Dude. Yeah. A lot of people that I went to school with are working at like Boeing and shit.
Yeah.
Like what the fuck?
That's crazy.
Yeah.
Dude, what if we had a Mormon president and they tried to fucking become like a dictator and then all of a sudden all of us had to wear those fancy undergarments?
I would only pee in mine and I would never wash it. It's just a big piss stain. Like,
hell yeah,
this dude is what you wanted.
Yo, so fucking, this is going to be wild, but listen to this. Fucking Glacian is in pull-ups because we're potty training.
Okay.
And he likes to just whip his dick out, and he just walks around in the house. He'll just pull his underwear down. And this is a problem, because he's a baby with a big fat gut, and it's like, can't ever tell. And the guy, he'll just be standing there next to you talking, and then all of a sudden, you're just getting pissed on, dude.
Oh, God. He's like, why you stop talking to me?
He doesn't even stop. Just he'll just be like, yeah, he'll just be like, and I'm like, what the fuck, man?
Hell yeah, dude.
Dude, so the reason that this is a really big problem is he does it at night when he's asleep. We have to put him in onesies now again, which is cold, so it's fine. But like the other day, I didn't. I just put him in pants. I put him in pants and a shirt. And then I went to go and get him in the morning. His whole bed was full of piss, dude. I was like,
right on,
I was
dude.
Like, dude, why? I just washed your fucking bed.
And he just continued to sleep in it?
Yeah, he just sleeps in the piss.
Fuck yeah, dude.
Like... Which, I mean, isn't entirely his fault. Sometimes he'll wake up in the middle of the night, but it's only for, like, he'll wake up and be like,
Whoa.
And I'm like, oh, okay. I'm going to go back to sleep. If it's anything more than, like, 30 seconds, I'll go get him. Because that usually means he dookied. But if he does something quick like that, I just assume that he fucking bonked his head. We just converted him over to the fucking, the bed instead of the crib now. And every night, dude, I hear fucking...
Just bonking his shit.
He rolls out of the bed, dude.
Oh, he falls out? Yeah. Jesus.
It's not. It's like a 5-inch drop. It's not massive.
Oh, I got you.
But it's. Imagine you're asleep and you fall. Land on the ground. Dude, and it happens every night. And then I have to, sometimes I'll go in there, but the last two nights I've just let it happen because it only lasts like 45 seconds. He's really mad and then he climbs back up in bed and he goes to sleep. He's fine.
Dude, Mary Chrysler.
Yeah.
What song of the week this week, dude?
You know, I don't know. I've been putting some thought into it. And the thing is like I've had a bunch of ideas rattle around, or I have, and none of them have been good.
Mm.
Your favorite song from a Fast and Furious soundtrack, dude? I got one.
Okay. Is yours from Tokyo Drift?
It's from the first one.
Okay. Is it POD?
No.
Okay, it's, yeah,
just cringy.
Let's do it.
I love the little small YouTube RC community, because this guy has 1,000 views on this video, 139 comments. Every comment he's responded to, and I just posted a comment on it saying, hey, nice looking truck, dude, because it's one that he built from the ground up. Immediately liked it. It's a 3-week-old video. And I'm sure...
That shit is hard to keep up with, too.
This guy has to be full-timing it, because his upload frequency is like every 2 or 3 days. Because
we get a bitch load of comments.
Where is he getting the money, though? The trucks that he's building are like $400 or $500 trucks. Dude, he's got a new one every week.
Well, YouTube pays decent, right? But on top of that, he's probably got sponsors.
Probably, yeah.
And they it's probably the car people, and they give him the cars.
He's only got 6,000 fucking subscribers.
Oh, weird.
But that's what I'm saying. His comments are, dude, he's got a 1-to-10 ratio of views to comments. That's insane.
You go first.
All right, so we're doing Song of the Week this week, and we picked songs from the Fast and Furious soundtracks. Different movies, I think. I'm not sure. But I wanted to get something, the classic from the first movie, so I went with the song that plays during the raid scene when the FBI is, like, busting in on fucking, what's the guy's name? The guy with the Honda S2000, and he fucking...
What, Han? Oh, wait. Sorry.
Not Han, no.
Oh, the bad guy from the first
movie. Yeah, what's his fucking name?
I don't know.
God damn it, dude. It's been a long time, but... This is Debonair by Dope, and it's got this really sick, it's industrial metal, you know, so it's kind of lame, but it's got a cool beat. I think it's just a motor beat.
Yeah, that movie is busting.
Yeah. The first movie is the peak of the whole series. It's
fucking good.
Perfect.
But, dude, yeah, so that's the scene where he's you fucking hate him more because you realize that his family is extremely rich.
Yeah. Yeah, and then, like, they're working
and
on the car.
And his dad slaps him in the face, and you're like, yeah, fuck you!
Yeah, and fucking Dom and Letty are, like, fucking and working on the car at the same time that that's happening.
Hell yeah.
Yeah, it's... But, yeah, classic song. Dope's amazing.
And then he's like...
I'm not a fucking narc.
Yeah, he's like, I didn't narc on nobody. That's what it is. I didn't narc on nobody.
Yeah. Stupid. Yeah.
Hell yeah,
real
dude.
Real product of its times.
Dominic Toretto. Yeah. The man, the myth, the legend. And I'm going to use his fucking... I mean, this is his song, right? This is every time like he's walking in slow-mo, this song pops up.
When I think of his song, I always think of the song that plays the first time that they're at the sandwich shop and he's in the back.
Is it not this one?
It's not this one, I don't think. It might be. Play it.
Yo! Tengo Calderón. Don Omar. Los Bandoleros.
Anyway, I feel like, yeah, that's definitely, like, it plays, like, 4 times in the first movie.
Yeah, but I remember something a little different. I'm going to look at this really quick.
We at the room, me and my crew.
Yeah.
Doodly-doo.
Yeah. Man. But, yeah, dude, I mean, what it did for car culture in America is crazy.
Oh, yeah.
It's insane.
Dude, oh, fuck, man. So, I got into, there are obviously a lot of car guys in the military. So, when I was, like, 19... I was hanging out with all these car dudes, and then they all have like cool shit, right? And so I start watching the Fast and Furious because they fucking like it. And then I'm watching it, I'm like, fuck! And I got really into wanting to like get a fucking car like that. Like, the thing that kept me sane was I don't know how to work on cars. I didn't grow up around it. So I'm like, thank God I didn't spend $40,000 on
a car that breaks down every week.
Right?
Yeah. That's the problem with as soon as you start messing with cars, even if you're like really know what you're doing, it's not going to last as long as it would factory, man.
I mean, they almost got me because when I had the fucking VR6 Jetta or whatever. What
a horrible car, too. To
I know, but they had body kits for it.
Yeah.
So I was like, I'm going to get a body kit. And oh, then I'm going to soup it up.
Yeah, you would have riced that bitch clean, God. Dude.
Good rough. Yeah, dude.
That's the, like, I know what you mean because I fucking have the Nissan, you know, and I really wanted to restore it and make it a lowrider because that was what me and my dad always wanted to do. And why the fuck would I want to restore that truck instead of do a resto mod, you know, like change the motor? Why did I spend almost $3,000 on a fucking 2-liter motor that makes like 89 horsepower?
Right.
Yeah. Why? For the same amount of money, I could have fucking got a brand new Chevy V8 and put in it.
Right. I don't know, man.
It's so stupid.
But another thing that was cool about that car was because I had just gotten to Fast and Furious, and in the first movie, Jesse or whatever, the guy that gets shot up.
Yeah, he's got a Jetta.
He's got a Mark III.
Yeah. Is this a VR5 or VR6?
I don't know. It's a Mark III. I don't know what the engine is, though. Mm. He was a cool guy.
Yeah.
And then he got shot the fuck up.
He's in a movie called I Spit on Your Grave where him and a bunch of other guys rape this girl
death
in the woods. Yeah. And then she comes back from the dead and then starts killing them all off. But he's like this really autistic guy and he's got a rubber band and he does this all the time and he flicks it. And at the end of the movie, she has a fucking trigger going or rope going from that thing on his wrist to the barrel or to the trigger of a shotgun that shoved up one of her other rapist's asshole. And he wakes up and he's like, and fucking blows the other guy to bits, dude.
What the fuck? What is this movie, dude?
It's a rough movie, but if you like gore and shit, it's a good one.
I hate gore.
Yeah, so it's like rape jigsaw or rape saw, basically. Yeah.
Shit, yeah, I hate gore movies.
Like, there's one dude. She takes the one guy who fucking was the guy who had the camera, and he fucking rigs it up so the camera's recording him. But she turns the screen around, and she shows like fish guts in his eyes, so he has to watch as fucking birds come and start pecking his eyeballs out,
dude.
Which I guess you don't really watch it because like. After they peck your eyeballs out.
Then you can't see anything.
Yeah.
Dude, have you ever seen Chronicle? That one where they have the shitty camcorder the whole time?
No. Nope.
And there's three dudes and they go and they find this like meteorite and it gives them powers. Like Superman powers. Okay, they have Superman powers, but it's fucked up. You should watch it. Mm. It's like they get the powers and they all get corrupted. And then one of them like realizes that they've been corrupted. One of them goes up and they can pretty much control anything in the world. So they're like, one of them like gets pissed off and gets struck by light. Or no, one of them starts killing the rest of the guys off because he's like, I should be the only one with powers or whatever.
This is literally the plot to the Miracle Man shit that I was telling you about.
Oh, you should watch it, man. Chronicle.
You should read Miracle Man. I'll watch it though. It doesn't like it's up my alley.
But yeah, he fucking electrocutes one with a lightning bolt, kills him, and then he plays it off like it was like, no, it was just a random lightning.
Yeah.
And then, some guy's like, I know you fucking killed him or whatever, like later on. And they were like brothers and he pretty much had to kill him. So he fucking telekinesis his ass with a giant spear.
Something that was never really explained in Nope. Where did the fucking coin come from that killed his dad? The nickel that went through his dad's head.
Shit, I don't know. Magneto? Yeah. And didn't that happen in Magneto? They use a coin and it goes through somebody's head.
Yeah, he does something even more fucked up. He has that one guy eat, they put iron pills in the guy's drink. Mystique does, and he drinks a bunch of the iron pills. And when he comes in to work, when Magneto's in prison, he fucking takes his blood out. Yeah.
That's fucked up.
Fucking straight blood bends his ass, dude.
Damn, bro. Yeah. That's kind of sick, though.
Dude, that's disgusting is what it is, dude. Yeah. Imagine you just get the guy like so drunk that they're literally like putting like ball bearings down his throat, dude. Just like, and then Magneto's just like, and it comes big hole in your gut. Or even worse, like Magneto could do some really fucked up shit. Like the amount of control he's got, and he makes like 20 ball bearings come flying out of your dick.
Or he could just actually control you.
That would be the other.
Man, you know, he could pretend like you're Superman, though.
Yeah.
Just like, oh, wait, we got Superman now?
Oh, dude, yeah, imagine that. That you know, dude, yeah.
That'd be kind of wild.
But what if he just fucking controlled Wolverine, just like, didn't even do anything fucked up, but just like controlled Wolverine. And just like a normal
he can't though, right? Because he can't like bend the adamantium, or
he definitely can.
Oh, then why does he not fuck him up?
I don't know, but even in the movies, remember in the movie, he fucking just has him pinned against the wall and then makes him stab himself in the first X-Men movie.
Oh, that's wild. He can't just rip his bones out of his body?
I don't know. I'm pretty sure he can't. I don't think he can tear them because of the way that the fucking adamantium is.
I mean, you could probably kill him by ripping his fucking bones out of his body.
But I don't think you can remove them from each other because they're all, like, joined.
Oh.
So I think that his
bones... But you could remove all of his organs and skin and shit.
They're not made of metal, though.
Yeah, but it would end his life.
It won't. It won't. It genuinely won't. They've taken his head off and he's fucking come back.
He'll just generate bones and stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah, but then he would no longer have the metal. So then...
Yeah, but you can't separate the metal. That's the thing with him. Like, there's... they've encountered it a bunch of times. Like, people will fucking shoot him in the brain, even with an adamantium bullet, you know, like they did in the fucking X-Men Origins movie. All it does is fuck his brain up. Still regrows. Yeah, he's just a baby for like 5 minutes.
No, yeah, but like, if you took all of that... If he could just bend all that shit out of him, then... He no longer has it.
That's true, yeah. Because it's not like his body's going to reform the bones. So I guess he can't bend the... It's adamantium, right?
Yeah.
I always forget. What's stronger, vibranium or adamantium? I think it's...
I mean, they say it's like the strongest metal, right?
Yeah, but they also say that about vibranium.
Dude, what if you pulled the fucking his bones out of his body and then morphed them together into a ball and just...
Yeah, vibranium is stronger than adamantium, so he wouldn't be able to cut through Cap's shield with his claws, which Cap? Is relevant. Yeah, Captain America.
Oh.
That's pretty wild when you think about it.
That Who made it? The Captain America shield?
Tony Stark's dad. In the Marvel movies.
Tony Stark's dad?
In the movies, yeah, Howard Stark. I don't know who does it in the comics, because, you know, when the original Captain America came about, I don't think it was vibranium back then. I think it was just a metal shield. I don't know when in the time, because, you know, Captain America's been around since the 1930s.
Yeah, because it's always steel, though, because steel was the hardest shit of all time.
Has to have been, right? Because
you got Man of Steel, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So. Yeah.
And it also seems super American to support the steel industry, which is like one of our biggest fucking industries. I don't know, honestly. I don't know when it started being vibranium. Maybe it started being vibranium in the MCU. I've never read Captain America comics. I have a couple of one-shots and a couple of, like, mid-run issues, and I've tried reading them, and they just don't interest me at all.
I'm not a fan, and I think they fucking... I don't know. Captain America 1 was okay. Not really, but then you've got, like, later it's on just, in the Avengers, it's just annoying.
It's just hard for me to give a fuck, because it's just like, what's his powers? He's just a strong man.
Yeah, but then, like, now, what, he can run the mile in 30 seconds?
Yeah, I mean, he always has had increased speed. Like that's the thing, is that he's literally just man, but better in every way. That's it.
He is smarter, now the Flash. Stronger.
Like, no, he can't keep up with Quicksilver or anything like that.
I know, but like, he could literally just, like, imagine him run, like, oh, I gotta run away. Nope, you're not getting away, because Captain America can kill everybody on the battlefield and then follow your ass and get you.
I know, but the thing is if you put him against an actual supervillain, he's immediately just a guy. Captain America versus Ultron one-on-one?
Yeah.
No, not a chance.
Right.
Even Iron Man, he can hack it. Like, there's ways around it. Captain America's only superpower is punch you in the face. That is it.
Yeah.
He's really lame, dude. And his enemies always reflect that, too. So his enemies are always just, oh, it's a Nazi.
I think it'd be cooler if he didn't get powers and they just made him stronger.
Yeah.
Like, he is naturally, like, they just gave him an injection and he got stronger. But he has to, like, keep up with it, right, and maintain it.
Yeah, I mean...
That'd be, like, way cooler, because now he's just a war hero.
Mm-hmm.
And he's just a normal guy that's
and
a war hero.
And I tell you something, I wouldn't read that comic. It sounds very uninteresting to me. They have that, what you're talking about. They have books like Men of Wrath and G.I. Combat, I think is what the DC one is. Where that it's just that. It's these fucking regular military guys that are just heroes.
It'd be a good movie, though. But then you'd only have to, like... Then you wouldn't have to have the whole fucking injection thing.
Yeah, but what I'm saying is that as a superhero character, he's weak sauce. It's just not cool. Not cool. Iron Man is also not cool.
What about Batman?
Batman, objectively cool, because he does the cringy fucking, I'm the Dark Knight.
Yeah, I don't like his movies.
Yeah, I'm going to say that the thing is that I don't think that there's a way to really accurately match the comics to the movies. Because I've read a lot of the comics recently. I read some of the, I think it was Frank Miller, but really gritty, really, really dark, really raunchy. Like, holy shit, dude.
Batman's Actually, I think Batman's fucking purpose is kind of lame, too.
What do you think his purpose is? What is it? Clean up his city.
Yeah.
That's it.
Yeah.
I think it's cool.
Fuck off.
I think it's solid.
I mean, I guess that's everybody's superhero purpose.
Yeah, but I mean, like, it's different for him. Like, he's got the personal thing of his family was murdered in the alleyway of the city that he loves.
I don't like it.
I mean, in the grand scheme, it's definitely...
I think it's too, because, like, okay. You had that anger for a while, but you never got over it, and you're still mad?
Yeah, because he refuses to go get
Fuck
therapy
off,
or take
dude.
Any meds for it. Yeah, he's just got severe fucking trauma.
Yeah.
Can't get over it.
Dude, other people's parents have been murdered.
I know, right.
Okay.
Whatever. The thing is, though, about Batman that's kind of weak is that they always try to keep him as part of the Trinity, so they always have to keep him on par with Superman and Wonder Woman.
Yeah.
How many fucking hoops do you got to jump through to be like, this guy could beat Superman?
Yeah. Guy with no powers can beat Superman.
Yeah. They're like, yeah, but he's super smart. And the whole thing is, every Batman fan on the face of the planet, this is what makes him so annoying. They're all like, Batman with planning could beat anything. It's like, dude, yeah, sure. Batman with planning. But here's the problem. You're not going to be able to plan everything, dude.
But no, that's not true. He's not super smart.
He also gets killed.
He's a smart guy. He never got any powers.
No, yeah. He's just a naturally smart. Yeah, he's not like fucking...
Yeah, he's not... Doesn't have power, super smart, because you've got, like, the Thinker from The Flash.
Yeah.
That dude has super smart.
I'm not saying he's, like, fucking quantum intelligence, but what I'm saying is that he's smart enough that
he couldn't outthink everything.
No.
Yeah.
No, he's a tactician, you know? That's his
whole
thing.
And I can't imagine that he could outthink Superman's powers.
Basically, yeah, here's the thing. Basically, yeah, he can. They say kryptonite. Yeah, he's always got kryptonite on him. Always.
Oh, okay.
Always.
I got a kryptonite dick, bitch.
Yeah, he's always got kryptonite on him, dude.
Hell yeah.
He has a safeguard for everybody. It's crazy. He really does. He's got the back doors for Cyborg. You know, he's got a program in there that he can activate by saying a single word to just shut Cyborg down. Like, and then you see that, like, the Justice League, the Doom movie, you know, where he's got a plan to kill everybody, including Superman. Like, and they almost work. He's got this weird trap that puts a bomb in the Flash, and if the Flash ever stops moving below a certain speed, it'll kill him. So he's, like, out there hyperspeed running, and you know how it's, like, his metabolism is just turning him into fucking bones. Dude,
there's
dying.
Always that shit, man. They're always doing that to the Flash.
I know. It's a tough gig.
Like, you either can't run, or you're going to run consistently forever.
I know, but how else are you going to hurt the Flash? That's the problem with the Flash. He's an inherently broken character, because anything else you do, he just fucking, I'm running back in time 5 minutes.
Also, he has, like, speed healing, too, so.
Everything. There's nothing you can do to the Flash. That's why.
Just fucking rip his leg off. And
that is the whole reason why in the fucking Injustice, they kill him immediately. Because if they didn't do it.
Yeah, he would just go fuck around everybody.
Yeah. Like, there's nothing you can do.
Captain Boomerang, man! Boomer Man!
I think that's another thing that's really funny about the Flash, too, is he's, like, one of the most broken characters ever, but 90% of his rogues galleries is just, like, regular fucking people.
I'm a trickster. I made a bomb.
even shit like fucking him against Mirror Master. I'm like, how is this a thing? How is this a challenge? We know he can move faster than the speed of light.
I think they have really creative bad guys, though.
They do. It's neat.
Pretty cool, yeah.
It's neat. Like, Weather Wizard's cool and all that. But, like, Grodd. Oh, Glacian got a Gorilla Grodd Imagine X playset. He's got way more of the Imagine X people than Gideon now.
I like Grodd, but I don't think that he's Flash's nemesis, though.
No, I know. Everybody says that. Yeah. It's weird, because, again, every time I think of the Flash, I think of Reverse Flash.
It's Reverse Flash. It's Reverse Flash. Yeah, that's the whole purpose Reverse Flash exists, is to be the nemesis of Flash.
I think he's one of the best bad guys, because
he's great.
He's amazing. It's just such a spiteful character. He doesn't give a fuck.
Yeah, that's his purpose. Like, that's why he exists.
He cares so little that he wants to fuck up the Flash to the point where every time he fucks around the past, he knows it could make it so he's never born. And he doesn't even care.
Yeah, dude. He's a G, man.
He's fucking the worst.
I
love him.
There's one, though, where he, like, I forgot what he does to get in this situation, but he is the Flash at one point. Yeah. Like, he switches roles, and the Flash is, now Barry Allen is the Reverse Flash.
Yeah.
And he's just, like, it happens in an instant for Barry Allen. So, like, one day he's married to Iris West, and then the next day, Reverse Flash is fucking his wife. And he's just like, he's like, what's up, Barry? Like, what's going on? Like, I'm fucking your wife. And he's like, what the fuck? And it's just like, dude, it's been like 20 years.
he's like, careful now. Don't push your luck. If you make me reset it again, I'll be fucking your dad.
Dude. I'm like, damn, Reverse Flash pulled a fast one of those.
Dude,
like,
that's
like, goddamn.
That's the thing, though. Like, if you really want to make a big hit on the scene. You're the Reverse Flash. You're like, how can I fuck the Flash's image completely, right?
Yeah.
First thing you do, steal his coat, right? Because nobody else can move as fast as him right yet. So you're Speedster in the red suit. You're the Flash. Uh-huh. Everything you do, everybody's going to be like, the Flash did that. So you go to the local park. Okay. You go to the local zoo, and you jack off every animal in the zoo. And then you just fucking, that's it. That's all you do. And then it'll be all over the news. They'll be like, the Flash?
Why is there nut all over the zoo? Yeah.
What's going on? Dude, like, imagine you're the Flash, and you're just like,
who could nut this much?
Yeah, you're just, no, like, it's visibly all the animals, because the fucking, you know, the
that. Oh, he slows down just to be on the camera, like.
Yeah, right at the end, he just looks up, and he's gone. Yeah. Dude. Perfect. Completely soiled the Flash. And he does that in the Lego
movie. Here's the thing. Basically. Why didn't he, instead of swallowing that one guy and pretending to be the dude in the wheelchair?
I haven't seen it, so yeah.
He could have eaten the Flash. Like, wait till the Flash gets his powers and then eat his ass and get in his suit. And then now you are the Flash.
Yeah.
I mean, I guess you would never exist at that point.
Yeah,
Flash has to exist.
Yeah, he needs. That's the thing that's so cool about his dynamic. That's what makes DC characters, I think, more interesting. Because like Joker and Batman, they have that. They really need each other to keep going. You know, and then you know you got like fucking Flash and Reverse Flash, and they really need each other to keep going.
I'll tell you what, though, the Reverse Flash in the CW show always has a leg up on the Flash.
I think he does always ever.
Oh, okay.
The Reverse
just
Flash.
Because he lives like 30 years past him.
No, it's not 30 years. He's like two centuries. He's from the year 3000 and something. Yeah. He's
yeah. Still, like, fuck.
Yeah. He's all like,
why do you hate him so much?
Oh, because the Flash Museum, they say that he's the greatest superhero who ever lived. Yeah.
Fuck this guy.
Yeah, pretty much. He gets a job. He's like working at the Flash Museum too. Is the thing
that's hilarious. Yeah, he's just a janitor. Like, yeah,
dude, something what? Like that. I think he's a curator. Like, I think he's obsessed with the Flash. So he gets the job as a curator, and then like somehow becomes disenfranchised with him, and then his obsession goes to the next level, which is hate.
Wild.
Yeah, it's interesting. He's a fucking crazy guy. I love his name. Eobard Thawne is like one of honestly the coolest fucking.
Yeah,
names.
Dude, it's wild.
Whoever sat down and was all like, we need to come up with a 30th century name, and that's the name they came up with?
There's something weird that happens. I haven't seen it in a long time, but there's something weird that happens. Like, Thawne is, there's a guy named Thawne. His last name is like, his Eddie Thawne or whatever. And he is partners with, or he's partners with Iris's dad at the police academy. And eventually, it comes down to where it's like, okay, the Reverse Flash is fucking everything up forever. So Eddie shoots himself in the fucking chest and kills himself. And so now the Reverse Flash doesn't exist because that's his like great grandpa or some shit.
Yeah.
Somehow, Reverse Flash like just continues to exist.
Yeah. He does that a lot.
What?
It's like, remember the one where he didn't have a brain anymore and he's like, I'm just vibrating so fast that.
Yeah. Like, what? dude, and the way that he got his speed, he like created his own speed force in the CW show, at least.
Yeah, I don't.
And it's like, that's fucking crazy.
Yeah, I know in the Lego version. It's
called the negative force.
In the Lego version, he knows about the speed force and is able to run in the speed force. And I'm pretty sure in the comics he can too.
He does in. That's wild when it gets into this point in the CW show, because he's got his own speed force,
yeah,
but he's able to like infiltrate the fucking actual speed force.
Cool.
And shit. It's fucking weird.
So Gideon got a book the other day from the Goodwill. It's like a list of all of the Marvel superheroes who matter. And something that I thought was cool was it has Quasar in it, which he's been dead for like 20 years in the comics.
Quasar.
Yeah, it's not been that long, I guess. I don't remember when the, when was the Annihilation? Might have been 2010. I don't really remember. But it's been a long fucking time. Quasar's been dead, canonically. And they put him in this book, and it just was weird that they put him in a kid's book, and it's got me wondering if they're going to bring him back soon. And that's something I'm excited for. I love, my favorite stuff that Marvel does is Space Marvel. You know, like Drax, fucking Quasar, Nova. Cool. Love it. Love the alien thing. I think that Marvel's alien space stuff is a little bit cooler than DC's. I've been trying to get into it. I've been reading some Adam Strange and, like, Hot Girl, you know, from Ran. But anyways, it just feels less cohesive and thought out than Marvel's. Marvel's got a really big effect.
Who does DC Comics? Like, who's the main guy?
What do you mean?
Like, you've got Stan Lee for Marvel, right?
I don't know. George Perez? I don't know. Stan Lee. I don't know.
Yeah, I feel like they don't have a Stan Lee.
I mean, Stan Lee... So, here's the thing, right? Like, Jack Kirby worked with Stan Lee forever, but then he went to DC. And he created, like, Etrigan the Demon and Apocalypse and all the, you know, all that stuff that's really dope. So, I mean, they had a lot of crossplay for sure. I don't know, man. I think when I think of DC Comics, I think of, like, Frank Miller and George Perez and Alan Moore. But those are all writers. So, I don't know. Maybe Ditko? I think Ditko. Let me look.
Mike Ditko? No,
never mind. Steve Ditko did fucking Peter Parker.
Oh, tough. Idea. Just look up who is DC's Stan Lee. And they're just going to be like, Stan Lee is from Marvel. That's probably what it's going to come up with.
Yeah, I pulled up his Wikipedia page.
Yeah, so. Yeah, they don't have one. I mean, I'm sure they have one, but he's not popular.
Yeah, I mean, it's just kind of different. Yeah. Yeah, they're talking about, like, right here, they said the biggest difference is that Stan Lee was an individual who really did most of the Marvel stuff, and DC was a publishing house with a bunch of people. And they're comparing Secret Wars and DC's Crisis on Infinite. And they're like, if you look at Secret Wars, it's like every character on there was fucking created by Stan Lee. Like, almost every character except for, like, two or three. It was either made by Stan Lee or Jack Kirby or Steve Ditko, one of those three. And then with the big, you know, DC thing, there's fucking, look how many different creators there are. But I mean, like, that's a problem, though. You know, like, that's the thing with DC is they picked up on these older comics, you know? So you have, like, Superman, which 1938 looks like. Of course, you know, you got, like, fucking Batman. Plastic Man's from 1941. So it's, like, all these different ones that were way before.
So DC has a lot of really good sidekicks.
Yeah.
Right? What are some Marvel sidekicks?
What do you mean?
Like, obviously, Batman and Robin is the, like, super so popular.
Would you consider, like, Iron Patriot or whatever?
For the Flash, Cisco, or, like, fucking...
Yeah, yeah, so, like, Rhodey for Iron Man.
Yes. Or, well, I don't know who Rhodey is.
Rhodey is,
But according to the movie, it would be, like, Potts would be his sidekick.
No, not even close. What are you talking about? Rhodey has a fucking suit and flies around with him.
Oh, no, the silver guy.
That's Rhodey.
Yeah, okay, yeah. That's his...
Pepper Potts is the lady he fucks.
Yeah, but also, like, she has, is, like, a huge role. Yeah, but I didn't remember him. But, yeah, he's the second guy.
Yeah, yeah. That's War Machine or Iron Patriot, whatever they call him. So there's, like, that. I don't know. When I think, like, the stuff that I read, like, Quasar works with Ego on a lot, but the thing is it's, like, not really a sidekick. It's hard to say.
Incrediboy.
Yeah, I'm trying to think, man.
Incrediboy is a villain, but
yeah, he went. Yeah. I don't know, man. Like a lot of the stuff that I read, that's Marvel stuff, is like group anyways. Like I read like the crossover events and the Guardians of the Galaxy.
I don't like
and
that
Avengers.
Shit, man. I want to get the source. Yeah, and it's so fucking hard to find.
But most of it doesn't interest me. Like, that's the thing. Like, all the Iron Man stuff, the one-shots and the individual, you know, his own special run, it's just dog shit writing. And
no, I want, like,
his character.
Issue one ever.
So that's, like, my Quasar. I have that. I have, like, the first 18 issues of Quasar.
Like, I want Flash original set, because I want to follow the Flash story.
Yeah, but then that's the thing, is that you'll be reading that, and it'll be one that hasn't been a canon thing since the 1950s, you know? Like, that's what sucks about old characters like that. You read the origin material and it's not, it doesn't matter anymore.
90% of it's like just propaganda for the war.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, that's, yeah, you know, like I made that mistake because I read the first couple of Plastic Man issues and he was like, he's like, look at all these Japs. And you got this fucking horrible cartoon guy. He's got big old buck teeth and he's all like, let's go to the store. it's so bad, dude.
Look at all these Japs.
Yeah, no.
Yeah, I know, it's fucked up.
It's so bad, dude. And then there's, like, ones, too, where he's, like, shitting on Jews, and I'm like, whoa.
Hey, you can do whatever you want back then, I guess.
1941, yeah, so it's before Pearl Harbor.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Everybody was racist. You could be openly racist, and then you were fine.
Yeah, it's crazy.
So you got fucking Captain America,
Yeah, I know.
That man.
He was a racist.
he had to be.
He's a fucking.
If you don't openly say he's not racist, he's fucking. You can just assume.
Blonde hair, blue eyes. Yeah.
He's a racist man.
Yeah. Get out of here.
That's American man right there. Yeah.
They're like, he wasn't racist. He was fucking a British woman.
I don't like that shit. Get out of here, Brits.
Yeah, dude, the thing is like, and it sucks too, because now I watch a lot of the RC YouTube videos for the last week, and if fucking most of the ones that have the best shit, like the highest quality audio and everything, they're all British, and I'm having to sit here and listen to this fucking idiot. He's butchering the English language, and I'm like, God damn.
British man butchering the English language is known as...
Park
life. Park life. Yeah, dude. Blur. All right, we're cutting it off. It's pretty good pod. Pretty good pod. Yep. We're going to do swimming techniques on the next one, so tune in.
I actually want to hit Austin with a couple of songs next week. I'm going to get three songs together, and I'm going to see if he can tell me which one of them is on a single coil and which one is on a humbucker. See if he can differentiate the guitar tones.
Between now and next week, we're both going to get dick extensions, and then we're going to cut them out on the pod.
Yes.
I'm going to be like, what is that made of? Yeah. What is the composite?
Yeah. Let's do a taste test. <You're> terrible.
Okay.
Don't taste your dick extensions.
All right, it's pod 33, almost coming up on a year.
Yeah.
In like 20.
Yeah, we got quite a few, yeah. Let's go get to 52.
Thanks, Obama.
Bacon cream pies. In your mom's eyes, bacon cream pies. All the time.
Nobody see my shoes.
I hate tomatoes, but I love ketchup.
Can't find it.
That's just a thing, and it's not even true.
Please, I have to drive home.
I think about you, and I have to say, it was hard to leave you alone.
I think I'm going to shit my pants.
Please, God, help me. Leave you alone.